Hey y'all, I'm Stay Hall.
And I'm Wallace Hall.
And together we are The Halls. And this is
The Hallway.
Today we just kind of wanted to talk to you all about soft skills as it pertains to a relationship, which would really be relationship skills. So a lot of people in this day and age are hearing about soft skills and emotional intelligence, and most of the time it's focused around career and business. But what a lot of people don't realize is we need to utilize those same types of skills within a relationship to make it work.
Right. A lot of people, like she said, a lot of people associate soft skills, things like that with that. But in our skills for as relationships, it's about communication. It's about understanding each other. It's about listening, active listening. A lot of those skills, things like that, that we want to incorporate in our day-to-day life that make us better partners, better spouses, better people overall, better parents in a lot of ways.
Right. And it's so funny. One of the major soft skills that we have been asked to come speak about at different businesses and corporations is team building. Well, when is it more important to know how to build a team and be effective than in a relationship? You have to know how to work with one another because you are two different people coming from two different backgrounds, but you should have the same common goals and you have to learn how to reach those together as a team.
Right. That's so true. You know, we talk about team building. You know, when we first started dating and got married, whatnot, we still do call ourselves Team Hall. Yes. And it's really about a team and how we work together. Sometimes someone's going to take the lead. Sometimes somebody's got to sit in the back. Sometimes the other person, and then it's a change around. It's time for the other person to take the lead. Another person. Sometimes it's going to be a 50-50 deal. But it's all about how you collaborate and work together for as a team. And that's what we try to create, a team environment where everybody has their strong points. And we try to make sure we accentuate those strong points for each other.
Yeah, that's exactly what I was thinking about. You have to be able to recognize and utilize each other's strong points, as well as be able to recognize some of your weaker points as well, so that you know that if this person is weak in this area, then this is where I need to step up. And if they're stronger in this area, then I can kind of back off and work on something else. Because when you're in a marriage, and especially when you're raising a family and maybe you have a business or whatever it is that you're doing, a lot of times you're juggling a lot of plates. And so it's so nice to know that not one person is responsible for all of it. We can kind of divide the responsibilities and tasks amongst the two of us, depending on who is better at what. And there shouldn't be any type of competition in a relationship as it pertains to that either.
Right. And investing in those skills and things like that are going to make you better. Spending time with us today hopefully is going to make you better. Just think about it like this. All of you that have businesses or work at a job or corporation, they have you guys go through trainings and things like that. And you wonder, why do I always have to go through this training? It is to make you a better team member, to make you a better employee, make you more productive. But we don't always spend that same amount of time investing in our relationships and our marriages and things like that. And that's what this is about today. So we can invest in each other, invest in our marriage, so make our marriages better. We got to spend that same amount of time, because really, Team Hall is a business.
Yes.
Whether we're doing this, whether we're doing our books, whether we're doing our other business or anything like that, it is a business. This relationship is a business. We have to be in it together, and each one has got to be doing their part and getting better so we bring more to the table. So we both can be successful. It's not about one being successful. It's about us being successful together. And the only way we can do that is by having these relationship skills or these soft skills that make us better and working together with that.
And another thing I just thought about while you were talking, we're talking about working as a team. And team, when most people think of that term, you think of sports and athletic events.
Right.
And so what a lot of sports teams have as well are cheerleaders. And so as you're working as a team in your relationship, you also have to be very, very intentional about being each other's cheerleader. You should be the biggest fan of your spouse, the loudest cheerleader for your spouse. Whenever they have accomplished anything, you should be screaming the loudest. You should be encouraging them and motivating them when they're in a slump, telling them, you can do it. Go team. You have to be able to be a cheerleader. And that is really a part of functioning together
right.
as a unit where we're not only working together, we are supporting each other, loving each other, and encouraging each other.
Yeah, in some of our marriage counseling sessions and things like that we've done helping other people, one of the things that always has always kind of troubled me is when relationships, when spouses or even, spouses, where we stay with that, spouses are competing with each other. Mm-hmm. I don't understand why are we competing with each other? What does it matter who gets the glory, who gets the accolades or anything like that? Because if I win, she wins. If she win, I win. That's just the whole part of the deal, because it is a team and working together and being someone else's cheerleader when we're doing different things. And when she gets a speaking engagement or something like that, I'm cheering for her. When I get a speaking engagement or something, she's cheering for me. So it doesn't matter. We're not in competition with each other. You know, the only competition is us against everybody else, but that's really not even a competition because we don't look at it like that. We look at it as us doing the things that we need to do to be the best that we can be to hopefully impact and share with other people.
And I know when I watch the Super Bowl, everybody on the winning team gets a ring, even those who sat on the bench. Because sometimes...
Even those in the front office.
Right. Yeah. It's important to sit on the bench, to be that support, to be that one to pick somebody up when they come on the sidelines and they're feeling down. I mean, everyone plays a role. And the thing is, in a relationship, there's only two of you. So it's even more important to know your role and to play that position at all times because there's no one else to fall back on. So you have to be a strong unit and a strong team and use those soft skills to really make it seamless.
Right. Sometimes, like I said, be willing to listen. Sometimes you got to put what you have going on to the side so you can be that cheerleader. You can be that support, be that sounding board a lot of times. When someone else has something going on, you shouldn't always make sure, I got to make sure my voice is heard. I got to make sure my voice is heard. Sometimes your voice needs to be muted a little bit so the other person who's doing something, so you can be supportive of them and help them do the things they do. Because trust me, you will get your turn because the way relationships work, your turn is coming. Just make sure you're doing your part to support your spouse.
Right. And when you say that your turn is coming, that works both ways. Your turn is coming where you're going to need somebody to support you. You're going to need someone to cheer
yes.
for you. You're going to need someone to be happy for you. And then your turn is coming where you're going to be on the flip side and you need to be that cheerleader, that supporter. And you always have to be aware of that because those positions are going to change from
yes.
time to time. But when you are in practice of doing it, when that's already the mindset that you have, it just kind of comes naturally.
Right. And like I said earlier, it's about us all being successful and no jealousy, no nothing like that. It is what it is. You know, you get to a point. I know some spouses have issue where someone maybe make more money than what the other person does. It's not a competition because guess what? It all comes into the same house. We talk about the hallway. It all comes into the same house. No matter if it's me this week, her next week, or however we're doing it, or even if it's her all year long or me all year long, it all comes into the same house because we're a team. And that's how we function. That's what works for us. And that's what we wanted to share.
Yeah, well, I thank you guys so much for tuning in. Please be sure to like this video. Also, hit that subscribe button
yes.
so that you can also be a part of Team Hall. And hit that notification bell so that you never miss a video. We appreciate you so much. Go, team, go. And we will see you next time in the hallway.